first guest is one of the most popular singers in music today. She's had hits with everyone from Rihanna to Nicki Minaj to Florida Georgia Line. Her new album is called Bebe. Give it up for Bebe Rexha! Congrats, you're breaking so many records lately. Hold on, I got a whole list. I gotta run it down. Okay, you're the longest charting female artist in the history of Billboard Hot Country and Billboard Dance Electronic with the most overall weeks spent at number one. I can't even comprehend that. At number one. How do you do that, and how do you feel?
Well, I started as a songwriter, you know, like from New York, just writing. I never expected anything like that. To me, it's like a blessing. I'm very grateful. It's crazy to think about, you know, so.
That's amazing. Yeah. I'm trying to get to your status right
there. Girl, you're like up here. I'm like down. I'm trying to get to your status.
Listen, I mean, you know, there's no one set path to success.
Yeah, it's
success,
true. That's so,
you know?
True.
Everybody create their own, and I just think that's so amazing for you to chart like that. That's
awesome.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Give her a hand. I'm a fan. Okay, do you remember the first song you ever wrote?
Oh my gosh, the first song I ever wrote, it was called Boy, You Know I Love You. and I was like, I don't even know, I was like 13, I was not in love. I will tell you, I was not.
Oh,
I don't
know. So where did the song come from then?
I don't know, I was just, yeah, I wanted to be in love, but it was interesting.
So did you start writing first or singing first?
I was always singing, but my path though, like, is really interesting because I had to write because I knew that, like, there's a power in the pen, you know?
Yeah.
Oh, man. Oh, gosh.
How old were you here?
I was maybe six.
You were six?
Yeah. So I started songwriting, but I knew that at the time when I was first starting out, I didn't look, you know, like, in the, you know how it is in the music business, you have to look like a certain type of pop star or whatever.
Yes.
So I knew that if I was able to get into the songwriting and start my songwriting, that would allow me to get into certain rooms.
Yeah.
So that's, I started my actual, like, professional career, like, at 17, and I had, like, my first big, like, K-pop song at 17, yeah.
At 17?
Yeah.
Oh, my God, that is amazing. Now, you grew up practicing singing in your room?
Yeah, I practiced trumpet for like 8 years.
Ooh.
And then I studied opera.
Oh.
And I will tell you, because we lived in an apartment.
Uh-huh.
Oh, man. Everybody.
They hurt you.
Everybody, everybody was complaining. Like, my family was annoyed, the neighbors were annoyed. I just never stopped because I got inspired at 12 in the morning, and I wanted to just write. I just loved it.
Yeah.
You know, you get that, it's exciting. You know, when you're first starting out, it's exciting.
Yes.
So I would never stop.
Do you come from a musical family?
No. I mean, my family's Albanian.
Uh-huh.
And, you know, that's what we listen to in the household a lot, like Albanian music, yeah.
And what does your family think about all your success?
Well, in the beginning, that's my family. In the beginning, my dad was kind of scared, you know, because he's an immigrant. So he's like, I don't want, you know, going to LA. It's sex, drugs, rock and roll, which it is. But they raised me really, like, I feel like they did a good job. And now that I can help pay for the bills and get them a car.
It's okay now.
They love it now. They
that
love
sounds
it
about
now.
Right.
They love it now.
I can see that. Oh, my God. Okay. Wow. Okay, but now I want to talk to you. You're outspoken about body positivity.
Yeah.
And I recently saw, you're beautiful,
you.
Honey. Let's be clear.
Thank
but
you.
I know this is something important to you, and you wanted to address it, and you did on your social.
Oh, on my Twitter, because I was on, like, TikTok, whatever, just looking at videos, and then a video of me popped up. And then I was like, let me read the comments, which you're not supposed
right.
to, that's the number one rule, don't read the comments. But I was like, let me read the comments. And the first thing up top was Bebe Rexha weight gain. And I was like, we're in, listen, we're in the public eye, so that's bound to happen, especially like I was a lot thinner and I did gain some weight. But it just, that comes with the territory, you know? Like, I'm not mad about it, because it is true, but it just, when you see things like that, it does mess with your, because you don't know what somebody's going through. Like, you don't know, like, what they're going through in their life.
Right.
So it kind of is tough. But I feel like we're in 2023. Like, we should not be talking about people's weight, you know? It's like...
You're right.
Listen. A girl like, I like to eat, okay? I like to eat.
And ain't nothing wrong with that.
I like to eat. And I went to the doctor like last year, and a lot of women actually have this and they don't know about it. But they diagnosed me with PCOS, which is polycystic ovary syndrome, and it's one of the leading causes of why women gain weight and are obese. Mm-hmm. And it's like I literally jumped like 30 pounds like so quickly. You know what I mean? I mean maybe a little bit more, but. But yeah, we gotta just be positive and just show people love and just like.
You better stand up and let them see. Girl, you better look good. Yes! She's back. Let's talk about this new album. Okay. It's called Bebe.
Yeah.
So everyone, what inspired you? What inspired this album? And that's a beautiful picture.
Thank you. Well, I mean, I've been in the game for like 10 years now. Mm. And I opened up the show for the Jonas Brothers one year. And I performed, and I started singing. And what I get a lot when I perform for people, it's like, wait, that's your song? Wait, that's your song? And I'm like, yeah. And I'm like, I feel like it's finally time that people, I really want people to know who I am.
Yes.
Like, who is Bebe Rexha? Because I feel like.
Yes. As they should.
Yeah. You know? Nice. And, I just wanted to write an album that was really reflective on change, mm-hmm. you know, but there's a lot of dance bops on there too, but there's female empowerment records on there. There's just stuff that I'm going through as a woman, you know, I'm a woman now, and it's yes. like, I wanna just talk about the things that are going through in my head, you know, it's my therapy.
Nice. And it's gonna be therapeutic for others too, I'm sure.
I hope so.
You got some, I mean, see, this is how you stay on all of them charts. So you work with Dolly Parton.
Yeah.
And Snoop Dogg.
Yeah.
Who does that? What is that like? And how do you even, you know, pull that together?
Oh, yeah, me and Snoop. Well, I actually, on this album, just hit up Snoop on Instagram. And I was like, hey, this is a long shot, but I have this song called Satellite. And it's about smoking a little bit, you know, that good stuff.
Of course.
And I said, you would be the perfect person on this record. Can I just send it to you? If you listen to it and you don't like it, I won't take it personal. I just think you'd be the perfect person on this song. And then he called me the next morning at 7 a.m. And he was like, check your email. And I was like,
that is true.
And I heard the song and I was like blown away. And we shot the music video together. It was so fun. He's so fun.
He is.
Dolly too.
What is it like working with her?
Oh, that's me and Dolly. I'm sorry, I keep seeing the pictures and I'm like, yeah, working with Dolly Parton. I mean, she's like somebody I really look up to because not only is she an amazing artist, but she started as a songwriter as well.
Right.
She wrote Whitney Houston, I Will Always Love You.
Oh, I know. You yeah. better know, I know. Yes, ma'am.
So, just like working with her, like, we shot the music video together, and she's so kind, but the one thing that I was like, really like, whoa, like, she is so funny. Like,
yeah, is she?
She is so funny. Like, I was cracking up the whole time. But then I also was like, just staring at her, and she had like 6-inch heels on, okay? A corset. Her boobs were like lift, like they were like up here. And I was like, girl, you look, she looks amazing. Like,
oh
she looks amazing. Like, she never ages. I'm like, I don't know what the secret is.
Man, now I gotta step my game up. Cause I had stopped wearing the heels. Okay, Miss Dolly, I'm gonna put my heels on and my corset. And then you do some crazy fun music videos. You just shot one on a yacht recently?
Oh gosh, yeah, for I'm Good. We shot one on a yacht, yeah.
And that is hot.
Yeah.
Girl.
Yeah, okay, but the thing is, you can kind of, I don't know if you could tell, you really can't tell, but the boat looks really nice, but it was a really old boat, and we were in Ibiza in the water, and like I don't know if there was a hydraulics or whatever you would call it, like was not really working. So everybody on board was like throwing up. Like, it was bad.
Oh.
Like, I mean, like, I have blackmail of all my team members, of them like passed out. I was telling myself, I was like, please don't throw up, because we had to shoot the music video the whole day. You know
yeah,
how it goes.
Yeah.
And I was like, if I throw up, I'm done for the whole day. And I was like performing and just like holding on and just
so
like.
So you was able to keep it together.
Oh, I kept that.
You
I kept
sold
it together.
The moment.
Yeah.
I mean, that's a true professional right there. Ooh, can we have a girlfriend moment?
Yeah, let's have a girlfriend moment.
Okay.
Go ahead.
You ready?
Yes.
All right, I got a few questions for you.
Uh-oh.
Who were you most nervous to perform in front of?
I would say I was doing this event, and I had to perform, me, myself, and I. And when I looked right in front of me, I was like, performing, and I'm like, wait, is that Mariah Carey? Ooh. And she sang along, but I did get really nervous, and my throat got dry, and I kind of cracked a little bit. But I feel like everybody was so, like, drunk that it didn't matter. So, but that was a really, yeah, it was Mariah Carey, I know. Crazy.
Well, if you're going to perform in front of anybody, I would say perform in front of Mariah, because she's very conscious and sensitive.
She got up, though, and she was singing along. She was actually, like, one of the only people that got up, and she was like, and I was like, aw.
That's Mariah.
Sweet. Yeah.
That's Mariah, so that was a good one. Okay, what's the worst date you've ever been on?
Oh, my gosh. I went on a date with this guy one time, and I don't know what was in his head or what he was on or what was going on, but we were in the middle of the restaurant, and he took his shirt off.
What?
To show his abs off, and I was trying to figure out. I was like texting my friends, call me, like maybe like there's a, like I need to get out of here, like I have an emergency, like something.
Did you get out?
Oh, I got out quick, girl.
How old were you when you had your first kiss?
Oh, I was I was 22, so I'm a late bloomer. Like
oh.
I was. Yeah, I know. I was a late bloomer. Like, just because I grew up in a... My dad would always scare the hell out of me. He'd be like, if you ever kiss a boy or bring a boy home or anything, like, you'll see... Like, he was really strict about boys. He was like, no. And I was like, okay. So I was, like, scared. I was,
you
like,
took him so, like, real serious.
I took him serious. So I was, like, scared. I was like, if I kiss a boy, like, am I gonna, like... What's gonna happen, you know? So I, like, when I kissed him the first time, I, like, looked around, like, make sure my dad's not there.
Adorable. I love that. I did not expect that answer.
I know.
Wow.
But everybody always thinks that I'm like, it's so funny because when I meet people, they always think that like, oh, you're in the pop world. You must be so promiscuous and crazy and this and that. And yeah, I do like to show my body and I like to be sexy, but not everybody can have this.
She said what she said. If you like this video, smash that like button and subscribe to the Jennifer Hudson Show YouTube channel. Check your local listings or visit jenniferhudsonshow.com to see when you can watch full episodes in your area. And don't forget to sign up for the newsletter.